Welcome to dear students. Today we shall study about the one important theorem. Before going to study about the theorem, I will give an activity here to understand the statement of the theorem. Here, activity is given here. So draw the figure like this. Okay, AB is one ray and CD is another ray, which are intersected at O. Angle 1, 2, 3, 4 are 4 angles are formed. Measure these 4 angles and give your opinion. Okay. Draw this figure in your exercise and measure 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4. And what is your conclusion? Give. So now, I think you have cleared. I will give the statement of the theorem. If two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles formed are equal. This is our statement of the theorem. If two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are equal. This is the statement of the theorem. Before going to prove logically, try to understand the one more statement, because it is necessary to logical proof of this theorem. Okay, here is a straight line AOB. So you know that this is a straight line, right angle is 180 degree. So therefore, angle AOB is 180 degree. Okay. So therefore, angle AOB is 180 degree. This is straight line. So similarly, if a ray OP stands on it, it divides this angle into two angles. See here, observe here. Now OP stands on it. This one angle divided into two angles. That is angle AOP and angle BOP, but angle is no change, so therefore that is 180 degree. 180 is divided into two, angle AOP plus angle BOP. Therefore angle AOB is divided into angle AOP plus angle BOP, but angle AOB is 180 degree, so therefore angle AOP and angle BOP, these sum of these two adjacent angle is equal to 180 degree. So therefore we can conclude, if a ray stands on a straight line, then the sum of the adjacent angle formed is equal to 180 degree. This is also called linear pair. Okay, this is also called linear pair. So angle AOP plus angle BOP equal to 180 degree. Therefore, if a ray stands on a straight line, then the sum of the adjacent angles formed is equal to 180 degree. Let us observe this video, try to understand this statement by using the construction. Here I am drawing a line PQ. Now O is the one point on that. So now O R is the ray stands on it. Now I am measuring the angle POR and angle QOR. See here, angle POR is 59 degree, angle QOR is 121 degree. So 121 plus 59 gives 180 degree. So therefore, if a ray stands on a straight line, then the sum of the adjacent angle formed is equal to 180 degree. So now let us see the another video. Let us see the another video here to understand the statement of the theorem. To understand the statement of the theorem, see here, I am drawing two lines Q and RS which are intersecting each other, PQ and RS which are intersecting each other at O. See here, RS which are intersecting at O, now I will measure the vertically opposite angle. So this side is say A, this side is B, this is C, this is D. Now I am measuring vertically opposite angle. See here, observe carefully. Angle POR is 80 degree. Similarly, angle QOS, which is opposite to that one, so that is also 80 degree. See here, one pair of vertically opposite angles are equal. Similarly, measuring other one, angle QR 100 degree, angle POS, which is also 100 degree. So 80, 80, 100, 100. So therefore, vertically opposite angles are equal. This is by construction. Now, let us move on to the logical proof. Let us move on to the logical proof. See here, first step is write the figure according to our assumption. Every statement consists of two. One is assumption and other is conclusion. Here, if two rays intersects each other, then vertically opposite angles, formed is assumption. Those vertically opposite angles are equal is conclusion. So therefore, now draw the figure. AB and CD are two lines which are intersected at O and angle formed 1, 2, 3, 4. So here data is according to this figure. AB and CD, AB and CD are two rays cuts at O, and we can write 1, 2, 3, 4 are angles. Okay. So now what is to prove? We are going to prove the vertically opposite angles are equal. What is that? What is that vertically opposite angles? Angle 1 and angle 3 are equal. Angle 2 and angle 4 are equal. This is our what we are going to prove. So to prove angle 1 equal to angle 3, angle 2 equal to angle 4. Okay. So now angle 1 plus 2 equal to 180 degree. This is linear pair. Similarly, angle 2 plus 3. So this is straight line. This is ray stands on it. So 2 plus 3 equal to 180 degree. So linear pair. From 1 and 2, 1 plus 2 equal to 2 plus 3. Angle 2 plus 3. So here 2, 2 cancel. Angle 2 cancel. Angle 1 equal to 3. Therefore, the lines, the things which are equal to the same thing are also equal. Because the things which are equal to the same thing are also equal. Therefore, angle 1 plus 2 equal to angle 2 plus 3. Here, angle 2 cancel. If the same things are subtracted from the equals, then the remainder is also equal. Therefore, angle 1 equal to angle 3. Similarly, now consider first angle 1 and 2 and then angle 2 and 3. Now angle 2 and 3, angle 3 and 4, then 3 becomes calm, it can cancelled. So that is the procedure. So angle 2 plus 3 is 180 degree, you know that. Similarly, angle 3 plus 4 is 180 degree because linear pair. So here also the right hand side 180, which are equal. So therefore, the things which are equal to the same thing are also equal. Angle 2 plus angle 3 equal to angle 3 plus 4. Here 3, 3 are same, cancel. Angle 2 equal to angle 4. Here we proved angle 1 equal to 3. Here we proved angle 2 equal to 4. Therefore, from this, if two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are proved. This is the proof, logical proof of the theorem. I think you are understand. Angle 1 plus 2. Why angle 1 plus 2 180 degree? Because CD is a straight line. OA is a ray stands on it. Therefore, 1 plus 2 equal to 180. Similarly, angle 2 plus 3. Consider in the same order. 1 plus 2 equal to 180. Similarly, 2 plus 3 equal to 180. Then 2 becomes common. Therefore, 1 equal to 3. Similarly, 2 plus 3 equal to 180. Angle 2 plus angle 3 equal to 180. Angle 3 plus 4 equal to 180. Angle 3 plus angle 4 equal to 180. So now 3 is common, so therefore angle 2 equal to angle 4. Therefore angle 1 equal to angle 3, angle 2 equal to angle 4. This is the proof of the theorem. Now I will give activity. Here is a problem. Find this angle BOC. In the second problem, find X and both these angle, that is PXR and RXQ. Okay. I am giving two other problems. Here this angle is 130 degree. Find the remaining angles here. Here this is find X and find the all other angles. Here four problems are given as an activity. So do try to solve these problems. So we will meet on the next class. Thank you.